हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज़ द लास्ट टॉपिक ऑफ बिजनेस स्टडीज चैप्टर सोर्स ऑफ फाइनेंस। वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ADRs, GDRs एंड IDRs। ADRs मीन अमेरिकन डिपॉजिटरी रिसीट, ग्लोबल देन GDR इज ग्लोबल डिपॉजिटरी रिसीट एंड IDR इज इंडियन डिपॉजिटरी रिसीट। फर्स्टली सी द अमेरिकन डिपॉजिटरी रिसीट ADRs। American depository receipts are those receipts which are issued by the company in USA. Then ADRs are bought and sold in American markets like regular stocks. These receipts can be listed only in New York Stock Exchange, that is in America. Now just to see the feature, first one is ADRs are in US dollar denomination, done. Second is ADRs can be listed on any American stock exchange only. Third is the holder of ADRs means who is actually having the American depository receipts, the holder of ADRs can get them converted into shares. It means ADRs can also be converted into shares if the holder desires. The holder of ADRs has no right to vote in the company, means the holder cannot participate in the management of the company and cannot suggest anything in the meetings. Fifth is a single ADR means one ADR can represent more than one share. For example, one ADR can be equal to the two number of shares. Sixth is the holder of ADRs received dividend as on shares dividend. Then second, we are having the global depository receipt. Global, as its name suggests that it is global. The GDR is an instrument. It is an instrument which the companies of the country issue in US dollar in order to obtain foreign capital. If any country desire capital from the foreign country, then they can issue global depository receipts, but in US dollar denomination, they can trade it in all those foreign share markets where they have been listed. For example, GDRs issued by Reliance Industries. Reliance Industries belongs to India, and suppose that GDRs issued by the Reliance Industries are listed on the New York Stock Exchange. Therefore, the transactions of sale and purchase of these GDRs can be made only on this stock exchange, means in the New York Stock Exchange. Now see the features of GDRs. GDRs can be listed on any American and European stock exchange. Then one GDR can represent more than one share. Means, for example, one GDR can be equal to two number of shares. And third, the holder of GDRs can get them converted into shares. These can also be converted into shares. And fourth one is, the holder of GDRs has no right to vote in the company. Means GDR holders also cannot participate in the management of the company. And fifth is, the dividend on these GDRs is like dividend on shares. Means the same like shares. Then GDRs are in US dollar denomination. Next is the Indian depository receipts. Indian depository receipts are like GDRs and ADRs, but IDRs are rupee denominated. So this is the basic difference. IDRs are rupee denominated. These are not in US dollar denominated. They can be listed on any Indian stock exchange. As name suggests, it is Indian. The Indian depository receipt is a specific Indian version of the similar GDRs. This is the Indian version. According to SEBI, SEBI means Security Exchange Board of India. It regulates trading of shares and stock in India. And this board is the apex authority which supervises the trading of shares in the entire country. And according to the SEBI guidelines, IDRs are issued to the Indian residents in the same way as domestic shares are issued. The issuer company makes a public offer in India and residents can bid in exactly the same format and method as they bid for the Indian shares. Done. As in India, according to the SEBI guidelines, if any company wants to issue shares, then they can publish it in the prospectus and general public can approach to the company for the bidding of share, means for the purchase of shares, and they quote the price. In the same way, companies can have the Indian depository receipts. Features of Indian depository receipts are, first one is, these are issued by any foreign company. Any foreign company can issue it. Second is, IDRs can be listed on Indian stock exchange. Okay, stock exchanges of India. Then a single IDR can represent more than one share, such as one Indian depository receipt is equal to 10 shares. Then fourth is, dividend on them is similar to the dividend on shares, means Indian depository receipts holder also gets the dividend like shares. The holder of IDRs have no right to vote in the company. Next is, the holder of IDRs can get them converted into shares. Fine, IDRs can also be converted into shares, but there is one condition, not before 1 year from the date of issue. And IDRs are in rupee denomination. As name suggests, it is Indian, so it would be in rupees denomination.